What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionRider.com. In this tutorial, I will show you how to alter the database using Alter Database DDL. For this purpose, I will be using the library database that we created in the previous tutorial. And the database management system will remain PostgreSQL. So let's get started.
Let's say you want to rename the database from library to new library. For that, the DDL will be to modify the database name, begin the statement with the reserve phrase alter database, followed by the current name of the database you wish to change, which in my case is library. Then specify the desired action, which in this case is rename to, and provide the new name for the database. Finally, conclude the statement with a semicolon to signify the end of the statement. Let's execute. Action done. During the creation of the library database, we assigned the owner as Postgres. However, suppose we wish to change the owner to HR. In that case, we can utilize the alter database DDL once again, like this. Again, the statement starts with the reserve phrase alter database, followed by the database name we wish to modify, which in this case is library. Next, we must specify the desired action, which is owner to. Finally, we need to mention the name of the new owner, which is HR. Let's execute. It's done. When we initially created the database, we designated the default table space as ts_users. In fact, I have a tutorial available that details how to create this table space, which you can access via the link on your screen or in the description. However, we now wish to switch the default table space from ts_users to ts_hr. To accomplish this, we will once again employ the alter database statement in the following manner. Again, the statement starts with the reserved phrase alter database, followed by the name of the database that we want to modify, which in my case is library. And then we have the action that we want this DDL to perform, which in this case is set table space, followed by the name of the table space that we want to set, which is ts_hr. Let's execute. It's done.
These are few of the most common modifications that we as a database administrator have to perform. I hope you found this video informative and enjoyable. If so, please show your support by giving it a thumbs up, subscribing to our channel and hitting the bell icon. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.